Hey, I really hate you all, so I'm gonna make you pretty. If you wanna know how to do this, stay tuned, watch my video and show you how. So we're going to go ahead and jump right into it. Here's what you'll need to create this project. First up, you're gonna need a bit of Mylar tape. I ordered this from Amazon.com. It was about $8. I ordered two rolls, but I only ended up using one. Next is masking tape. This is completely optional. I just use it as a guide on the sides and bottom of the wall. A pair of scissors. A cell phone or a laptop. You can also use a printout or even a sketch if you have it, if you're that creative. I unfortunately am not. Finally, the last thing I used was an X-Acto knife. I didn't picture it here, but it's also completely optional. For my reference photos, I always go to Society 6. This is the first image that I actually ended up using in my bedroom on my headboard, and I looked around and I couldn't find any other ones that I really, really loved, so I defaulted to Elizabeth Fredrickson, and she's the artist that created the print that I use on my headboard, so I went ahead and searched through her things again just to find another print to use on the wall in the living room. Obviously, she does some amazing work, and I came upon this one. I absolutely loved it, and then this is me just sort of switching through to find the very best version of it. I wanted to find an item that had enough of the print on there so that it kind of matched the scale of my living room wall, if that makes sense. They're telling me to add the cart. I'm not too broke for that, boo. Now scrolling, and still scrolling, and finally found one. So this is about the same scale proportion as my living room wall, so I'm gonna go ahead and use that one. So first up, I'm gonna set up my guidelines with a little bit of painter's tape. And then following this, I'm going to start removing the electrical switches just so that I have a nice flush design underneath, and then I'll reattach them once I'm done. So the first line that I choose to put down is this line that goes from the middle of the right to the top of the center of the print. And I choose this one because if you notice, the lines in the pattern kind of all branch out from each other. So this one's just the easiest to set, since the longer lines tend to be more difficult. You can see that the technique I used here, I just stretch out the tape along the length that I want to set it, lightly tap down on each end, and then pull one side to realign it if I feel it's not straight, and then press the entire length of the tape to flatten it out. Once I get my first line down, it's on to the rest of my anchor lines, which are the longest lines in the pattern, and I just kind of eyeball them out, and I make sure to hold over the tape at the ends, which makes it a little bit easier once I start cleaning it up. And then once I've done that, I can go ahead and work in quadrants or portions and tape down the rest, which is what you see here. So I'll just let you guys watch from here. So this is just a close-up shot of me putting up the last lines on the wall. A little tip of advice, if you do plan to do this on your own, you will need to make sure to press the tape in so that there are no air bubbles behind it, is what you see me doing here. And this just helps the design to stay up for a longer period of time. If you do not do this step, you may risk the tape actually coming off the wall, so you definitely want to double check to make sure that you're running over the length. And then once you're done, you are done. You don't have to seal, everything's good to go. And that is it. Go ahead and slap a cute little table in front of it, maybe light some candles, and pour yourself a glass of wine, because you worked hard and you deserve it. Hey guys, thank you so much for watching my video. If you'd like it to see, make sure to like down below. And if you have any comments or questions, go ahead and leave them in the comment section. I also have a video of me painting this glorious table that you see in the video. So if you'd like to see that, go ahead and comment down below and let me know. Have a great one. Bye!